Hello students, welcome back to our science classes. We are continuing our lesson friction. Our next one is mass of sliding object. So how friction will be affected if the mass increased or decreased, or what is the role of mass in the in friction? To understand this mass effect of mass, let us do another activity. So that is activity number 3 of this lesson. So for doing this, we need two or three books we can take, and a loop of cotton thread and spring balance and a table. These are the things required. Once again I will say, it needs two or three books, a loop of cotton thread and spring balance and a table. So we can see how can we arrange it. First, on a table, first we can take one book. We can, as we done earlier, we can tie it with the help of the thread. So we have taken the book, a book, and make a loop over the book and connect that loop to the loop of the spring balance. So we can connect it to the, we made a loop, and to the hook of the spring balance we have connected it. And what is the one book we have taken, loop of the cotton we have done here, and the spring balance we have connected, and everything done on the table. Now I have said you how can we measure the friction earlier. In the same manner we can measure the friction here. So we have connected the spring balance here, we have applied the force, then we can see what is the force here. That means what is the friction or frictional force we will get it from the spring balance. And in the next case, what we have to do, we have to add one more book to the above, we have to keep one more book above this book, then after that apply the force, or we have to pull this spring balance, then second time it shows that more force, because we know more force is required to pull it. If the more force is required to pull it, its friction will be more. And after that you can add one more book, so weight has been or mass has been increased again. Now it feels more force, or it feels difficulty to move it. That means the force applied, it will be more. That is the force applied, or that is the friction in the third case. So in the first case we have done, we have noted the reading in the spring balance, and second case we have noted the reading in spring balance, and third case also we have noted the reading in spring balance. And obviously we can say that in the third case the reading was more. That means as the mass increases, friction increases. As the mass increases, friction increases. So from these two activities, that means activity two, from the activity two and three, we can conclude that as the roughness increases, friction increases, and as the smoothness increases, friction decreases. And in the second case, mass of a sliding object, that means as the it is directly proportional, it is, friction is directly proportional to the mass. That means as the mass increases, friction also increases. And from this part we are also understanding that there is no surface is perfectly smooth. We may think that glass is smooth, but in science that also not perfectly smooth. If it is perfectly smooth, we won't be able to take it or hold it. Our next part is friction, a necessary evil. So in this part we are going to study advantages and disadvantages of friction. There itself you see the heading, friction a necessary evil. So it says that friction is an evil even though it is necessary. Friction is, in one way it is bad and other way it is good. So that is why the heading is given like this: friction, necessary evil. So first itself we can see why it is necessary. Why it is evil we can say later. Now we can say why friction is necessary. Suppose if you want to take your mobile phone, or if you want to take your textbook, or whatever the things, if you want to take or hold it, it is possible only with the help of friction. If there is no friction, we won't be able to take anything. For example, if you want to take the pen, if there is no friction, pen might be slipped out from your hand. Or if there is no friction, we won't be able to take a mobile phone, or you won't be able to take anything. So with the help of friction only we can hold the things or we can take the things. And another one, you people, or we can very easily or comfortably we can walk on the floor or we can walk on the ground. How it is possible? There will be friction between your leg or your shoes and floor or earth or ground. There will be friction. If there is no friction, what happened? Will be able to walk? No. Obviously, there will be no chance, there will be not possible to walk. Imagine that there is a tiled floor and if some oil is kept there, will it be possible to walk there? No, it won't be possible to walk because the friction will be minimum there. So we won't be able to walk there. And next one, suppose there is the door. If we want to open or close the door, what is needed? There should be the friction. If there is no friction, when we touch the door, what happens? It will be slipped. Your hands cannot hold the door. It will be slipped and it won't be possible to open or close it. And another one, we know in our room, almost all the things we can fix only with the help of nails. If there is no friction, will it be possible to fix a nail? No, definitely there won't be possible to fix a nail on the wall if there were no friction. And next one is, these are the things it says that friction is necessary. And one more thing, it is familiar one, that one also I will tell you now. Here, if you want to write something on the board, what is that? There should be friction between chalk piece and blackboard. If there is no friction, it won't be possible to write. Take a glass and take one chalk piece. Will it be possible to write on the glass? No, it won't be possible to write on the glass because glass offers least friction. As it offers least friction, it won't be possible to write. If you want to write on the blackboard, there should be friction between chalk piece and the board. And another one is, you can write, you are writing something on the textbook or notebook. If you want to write something on your notebook, there should be friction between textbook or notebook and pen or pencil. If there is no friction, it will be slipped. So you can see, if the textbook is laminated or notebook is laminated, will it be possible to write there? No, it won't be possible to write because there is no friction. So from this we came to know that friction is an evil. We didn't say that friction is an evil. Anyway, we came to know that friction is necessary. Without friction, our life won't be comfortable. Now let us do an activity to know the importance of friction. So for that we need a water bottle and some mustard oil. These are the main things we required for it. First we have to take the water bottle, remove the cap and fill it with water. And if any wrapper is there around or outside of the bottle, we have to remove it. Now bottle is there, only bottle, there is no other wrapper, bottle, and it is filled with water. Now try to take it with your hands. Yeah, it will be very easy to take. Now next, what we have to do, we have to keep that water on the table. Same water we have to keep on the water bottle, we have to keep on the table. And mustard oil, you have to take the mustard oil and apply it around the bottle and apply some mustard oil on your both hands also. Now try to take it. Will it be possible to take it? No, definitely you won't be able to hold the water bottle because it will slip down. definitely it will slip down because there is no friction. So if there is no friction, we won't be able to hold anything. So in this way we can say that friction plays a very, very important role in our daily life.